grim darkness of the far future, there is a war.
Welcome back, my friends. My name is Eric. This is Mellow7 Gaming, and today we are going to take a look at Gladius, or Gladius, depending on how you want to pronounce it, another Warhammer 40K computer game. Now, if the fact that I haven't 3D modeled and printed my own bolt pistols and plasma guns, I have CNC cut out Aquila plastered around the shop on the toolbox, it should be apparent that I like Warhammer 40K. I have played tabletop Rogue Trader, as well as, you know, any of the 8 billion computer games and console games that have come out for Warhammer 40K over the years. Now, the Warhammer franchise has not exactly covered itself with glory when it comes to computer games. They have proven time and time again that Games Workshop is more than willing to put their name on whatever random crap comes along. And so computer games can be a little bit hit or miss. Now, I've watched a chunk of this, a couple hours at least, 2-3 hours of this, and I could have sworn that I played it, but I can't find it installed on any of my game services. So I don't know if I dreamed it, if I'm misremembering watching other people play, or if there was actually a trial out that I played. I remember specifically, I was on the far left of the map going up, and there were a whole bunch of monsters that came down, Catachan devils and stuff, and Tyranids kept coming across and hovering units across the water. So who knows? God knows, maybe I even recorded some of it. Beats me, but we are gonna give it a try today. I've picked up the total game with all the 8 billion DLCs that came with it. I spent my $600, or it wasn't $600, but it was too much on this game. So we're gonna go ahead and take a look at it. So we can do all sorts of stuff here. Let's see what our options are. We've got Astra Militarum, which is my favorite by far. I am an Imperium of Man fan, right? The men and women of the Astra Militarum, just regular Joes like you and me, that stand up to the galactic whores day in and day out. Is where my loyalties lie. On the other hand, Chaos Space Marines probably look the coolest, right? I mean, there's definitely that. But let's say our initial challenge is hard. Billions of men susceptible to morale. Yeah, that's about right. That is about right, but artillery's awesome. We've got the Necrons. They say that they are easy. Okay, well, maybe we'll take a look at them. I don't know. I'm kind of ambivalent about the Necrons. I don't really care about them one way or the other. Some of them look really cool, some of them don't. I like kind of the more insecty stuff than just the, we forgot to put undead in this. We better come up with something so we have a faction that matches with Warhammer Fantasy completely. That's essentially what this is. Everybody loves orcs. Space Marines, okay. Tau are medium, okay. You know, they're Space Marines, right? I mean, that's just what it is, right? They have some cool stuff though. We'll probably start with them. I've always liked Tau. They've been either really good or really bad as far as tabletop, so nobody's really, there's a lot of people that have not liked them because they were either worthless or they were completely overpowered, depending on edition and that sort of stuff. You know, they're legitimately the only almost good guys in the galaxy, and even they're not very good because they're very much a greater good, and if you don't happen to be the greater good, suck it, you know. I do like Tyranids. I do have a tabletop Tyranid army at the moment. I have a tabletop Tyranid army, a tabletop Grey Knights, and at the moment I don't have a lot. I've got a Scion army more than anything else, which usually, when I was playing tabletop, would just get included in with my Grey Knights as a detachment. But I do like the Scions, and they are added in the game in one of the DLCs I saw, so that's very cool. Great Devourer, initial challenge hard, right? They're just there to eat everything. You can't go wrong with that. And then there's a spectator mode. That's pretty cool. Let's be honest. That's pretty cool. I like that too. You know what? We'll just jump into Space Marines. Initial challenge easy. Fortress City, single city that's deployed from orbit. Food and one resource are placed in a single soil-dependent requisition resource. Okay. Deploy fortification, gather resources, battle barge, deploy tactical operations such as scans and bombardments, and we get chapter tactics. One unbreakable shield against the coming darkness, one last blade forged in defiance of fate. The Emperor protects. Bolters blazing, the battle brothers of the Adeptus to start as crush the foes of the Imperium whenever they may be found. Each space marine is elite, genetically engineered, cybernetically enhanced super soldier, a mighty and fearless hero worth 100 lesser men. Each space marine is recruited into a 1,000-man chapter before they are extensively modified with 19 extra organs and the crucial chapter gene seed. From the numerous ultramarines and the mysterious dark angels to the fierce space wolves and tormented blood angels, each chapter has its own tradition and style of combat. Armed with the finest weapons the Imperium can provide, clad in suits of intimidating ceramite power armor, and born to war aboard swift and deadly fighting vehicles, they are the Imperium's ultimate weapon. Though relatively few in number, it is the Adeptus Astartes who represent humanity's best hope for survival, for they are the greatest warriors the galaxy has ever known. So yeah, we'll give it a try. Sure, we'll leave it on medium. We don't know. World size, medium, land size, medium, game pace, fine. Let's go for it. Let's see what we got. I haven't decided if I like Gladius my shadow behind me on the green screen or not.
Bastion of humanity, newly colonized. A suitable base for our chapter to rebuild and recruit. We space marines raised our fortress here. Grew strong again. But the orc invasion brought a warp storm that cut off our Emperor's light. And the dread necrons crawled from the earth beneath our feet. War was on all sides, yet we are the Emperor's chosen. We do not dread the dark, or quail at the relics of old. Terror is for those who oppose us. We know no fear.
All right, welcome to Gladius. To move the camera, position your mouse over the terrain, click and hold, and left mouse button, move your mouse. All right, once you're comfortable, select OK. Space Marines deploy from their most crucial, infrastructure from orbit to found your fortress, which is the backbone of your chapter on Gladius and elsewhere. Press the deploy city button on the operations panel. Deploy city, there we go. And select an empty tile in sight. Note that Space Marines can only have one city. All right, so where we put it is where it goes. Take your time to explore the interface. Every element has a hint, which provides you with extra information. Refer to the red task button on the right side of the screen. I guess that's that. It'll help you focus on our next task before you end your turn. All right, so we need to bring our city down, and we have two options. We can put it here, or we can put it here. Plus 20... All right, so this one's gonna get us this, which is a plus 40% of something. This one's gonna go back the other direction, which is gonna get us plus, well, let's just start here. We'll grab that one. It gets built bigger, so. And we unlock some achievements. That was easy. Cities gather resources to required to fuel your war machinery. The city screen displays all resource-related city. Hover your mouse over each resource to find out more. All right, so we've got our population. We've got a six limit. We've got one of six, and our limit is six at the moment from buildings. Growth indicates how fast the city grows, so it's going to grow 8 per turn. Does that mean we're going to go from 1 to, well, our max 6? Plus 8, 4 turns, it says there. So it says plus 8 per turn, and then it says... 8 4 turns. 0 of 32. That must be what it's requiring. So we get 8 per turn, and in 4 turns, we'll be at that 32 accumulated, for whatever that means. Requisitions. We get some from buildings, some from features, some from loyalty, and some from population, although we're not getting any from population at the moment. we're losing some. We do get some energy. We've got some research. We've got some influence. And we're getting a little bit of loyalty. All right. Cities gather resources. The city, yep, we already said that. All right, here buildings are listed with available actions. Note that all buildings of the same type or grouped together can only perform one action at a time, although multiple actions can be queued up. The required resources will be immediately subtracted from your pool. Okay. There are free building slots in the city. An opportune time to make plans to expand your army. Begin by constructing infantry production building. Click the blinking building icon and select a city tile. All right, so this one had three spots, right? That's that little three with the little deal, and this one has, says it's zero at the moment. There's something in it, so maybe we can't. Desert, Grox Pasture, Outpost. Here we've got Grassland, Space Marine City, and Great Hall. Okay. Okay, so. Are we supposed to build a Great Hall? It says we've already got a Great Hall. Right there. Great Hall, building that generates resources. Okay. What else we got here? We can acquire a tile. We can construct a refectory. Chapter's Mammoth dining halls and kitchens are contained within its refectories. The Space Marine diet is a Spartan affair. Okay. Requisitions 6. So it's going to get us 6 more, I assume? Or does it take 6? I guess we'll find out. A genitorium, energy, okay, we're probably gonna need that at some point. A librarium, an Asimilarium, sure. Sure, it's a gathering place with a big ceiling. Why don't they just call it the Great Hall? the Great Hall is the only room to exceed the sheer size of this Asimilarium. All right, and then we've got an apothecarian. And we can sleep, and we could acquire a tile. So if we were to do that, we could go kind of any of these directions. Grassland, Necron Tomb, and Rocks. 3 Grassland. Let's go there, and let's go ahead and build a refectory. We should have a spot there, yeah, because we do have the 1 Grassland spot, I believe. Order units. Okay, well, we've got a couple guys. Let's move them down. Okay, that... Yeah, right button, okay. Gladius is full of unknown treasure and vicious alien creatures. As you explore, you will recover, receive discovery notifications can be opened to reveal more information. Some terrain can be explored for rewards. While other features might hurt your unit, tread carefully. The planet's life can be ruthless, but if you leave it alone, it may spare you. Tiles with special resource features can be captured by moving a unit on them. This will construct a outpost, providing you with a small but important bonus to your resource output and giving the unit station their increased damage reduction healing rate. Defend your outposts, or they'll be taken over by other factions or the Gladius wildlife. All right, so does that mean we can go? We have to right click. How are you? Can you get there? Yes. The Ruins of Vol, which are now explored and got us 16 influence. Okay. There are Ruins of Vol in sight. These ruins provide rewards for the first player exploring them. Some even provide powerful ancient items that can be later equipped to make them stronger or excel. Okay. It's unclear what this is. Some time-worn structure rearing up from the shattered surface, made from the same impenetrable metal as the rare artifacts that dot the planet. Much can be learned merely from studying it, and perhaps it still houses some secrets itself. I don't know. Suffer not the Xenos to live and all that, right? To open the city screen, you can click on the city name, or click on the headquarters twice. You can also select the city's defenses by clicking on the headquarters itself or the icon above the city. All cities have limited firepower to defend themselves. Make sure to protect your city. All right. Choose research. We did that. Here we go. Begin by selecting technology from tier 1. You must research 2 technologies from the tier to unlock the subsequent. You can speed up by constructing additional research buildings. Note that all progress is lost when you change your currently researching technology. All right. So we've got tactical doctrine, which will increase the accuracy of my tactical space marines. Reclusium produces heroes as well as generates influence and increases. That sounds good. We can't do that because we need an armory. Operation to reveal the target title and adjacent tiles. Frag grenades are always good. Armory is really good to get the razor back. Let's go with the reclusium, though, to start with. See if we can get some heroes and some additional loyalty. I think that sounds cool. And exit city. In turn. As chapter master, the arrival of an enormous orc horde on your chapter's homeworld was calamitous. But no one ever said the Adeptus Astartes shirked a challenge. Yet, after months of fighting, the battle remained locked in a stalemate. You instructed the civilian planetary governor that Astra Militarum support was required. Clearing the green menace was a priority, whatever the blow to the chapter's pride. Barely had the guardsmen landed when a system-wide warp storm began, devastating the planet. Of your majestic fleet, a single battle barge in low orbit was the sole survivor. When the surface storms calmed, your surviving marines emerged into a ruined world. You were trapped on the planet's surface, cut off from the Imperium, and surrounded by Xeno species to boot. But you are the Emperor's own sons, the Space Marines, and you will not die easily, or in vain. Your chapter planned for every eventuality, so your fortress holds enough food and resources to survive decades of battle and siege. But more complex devices, ammunition, and war gear require the acquisitions of rare resources. To stand a chance of defeating the Xeno's menace, we need to secure the location of these key materials so that servitors and serfs can continuously extract them. Deploy Fortress of Redemption next to the special resource feature and secure the perimeter. Space Marines are able to issue strategic and tactical operations by expanding influence. One such operation is the deployment of a Fortress of Redemption, a stationary unit that secures adjacent special resource features. Placement of Fortresses of Redemption is key for Space Marines to gather resources beyond the city's reach. Okay. So. Am I supposed to put it here? Next to the special research feature, and I guess this is the special resource feature. I would think this would be the special resource feature, right? It's got the Grox pasture, but maybe not. I don't know if that's the right special resource. That gave me something. Yep, it worked. With the fortress built, focus your enemies on requisitioning the raw materials from the remaining population. All right, we got wire weed and rocks there. Don't know. Grassland Necron tomb, that doesn't sound good. And more Necron tombs there. Order units, all right. Let's go ahead and, left click to select them, right click to move them. Let's go ahead and we'll just kind of slide them this way and see if there's anything down here. We gotta be a little bit careful here. I guess that took two turns. I think we have two. We have three movement. It apparently took all of it. Okay. Each unit has a variety of statistics and attributes, traits, abilities, and weapons. Each have their own ranges and effects. Some might only have melee weapons, but move quickly through rough terrain, while others might have fear auras or unleash powerful artillery blasts. Move your mouse and icon over buttons in the selection panel to find out more about your unit. All right, so that's our armor, reduces the amount of damage taken. Each point of armor reduces the damage taken by approximately 8%. So we subtract a lot, up to 83%, right? So 8 times 8 is 64. All right. Some of weapons and abilities ignore some of that. All right, we got 15 hit points. Our morale below 66 become shaken, below 33 become broken. Number of actions, amount of movement, and level up. Okay. Kind of just want to verify there's not much else around there. Do we use all of it? Yeah. Uh-oh. Found some bad guys and some promethium relay pipes. Okay. I'm going to sit here. Oh, well, I think I don't have a choice. Yeah, I want to stay in the cover regardless. I'm not sure what those guys are doing, but we're going to see about moving up, and I don't know if we can take those or if we what the deal is. Okay, well, I guess we got it. For now, it did something. And we've got a Jokero trade encampment and outpost up there as well. Now, these guys... What is that, is the question. Because I see a dashed border there. Do you see that? We might be bringing dudes back here. Reclusium. Building that produces heroes. All right. Those rare ceremonies that require the attendance of every battle brother, the vastness of the Reclusium allows the entire chapter to gather. This is the most precious place in the Fortress Monastery, home to its most sacred relics, and in rare few, the very body of a Primarch. It is also the seat of the chapter's commanders and heroes. All right, so we could produce a captain, a librarian, or a chaplain, assuming we had those technologies. We have the technology for the captain. All right. I'm going to step forward here. A skull altar, unexplored. Okay. Terrain, forest, imperial ruins have increased movement. Height differences affect line of fire. All right. Let's go. Can we get in there? So many Xenos, so few bolts. Nope, we're out of movement there. Okay. And how's our city doing? Some units cannot move, but still perform actions. If they have weapons like city headquarters, they can attack. Okay. Oh, choose research, because we're done with our Reclusium. I think I can go armoring. We have our marines now. Let's make what we have better. Tips, transporters. To embark. Yeah, well, we didn't actually make any. But that's okay. How is our city doing? What is it building? Anything? Oh, we got two more units on the refectory. Okay. Intern. There they are. Do we shoot back? We took 2 damage. Okay. I'm gonna go here. Whoops. Take that outpost and then shoot. Yeah. They won't attack you as you move around, but attacking them will show. Oh, they did attack us, so, you know. Vespid sting wings. All right. And we can see they have 6 armor, 15 hit points. Okay. Not too bad. And then this guy is going to step into here. Skull altar provided blood blessing. Okay. Does that show up down here? Rising from the ground, the skull altar is formed out of the violent tributes heaped in offering for Khorne's throne. Okay. Skulls for the skull, throne, blood for the blood god, right? From atop the drizzly pedestal, a priest of Khorne roars out invectives, evoking the judgment of the blood god to smite down all signs of weakness. Okay. Oh, there's more of them, and we're losing people. That's not good. It's not good at all. Ouch. All right. Hold position. Hold position. Overwatch. Well, we probably should have had that on, huh? I'm going to hit heal and see if we can survive. Meanwhile, I'm going to see if we can move these guys up there to help defend in time, right? So, our city has now built the refectory. So if we go to requisitions, are we getting more from buildings? I think so. So it uses 1 energy, but it gives us 7 requisitions. This is giving us 6 minus 1 minus 3. So we're using 4 of our energy, I suppose. Yeah, which leaves us 2. Okay. So we probably want to maybe, I don't know what we want to build. Maybe more energy. Building that produces infantry, as well as in, well, we're probably gonna need that. Let's get building some infantry. And I think that's the end of our turn. Okay, we took a little bit of damage. Lost another dude. What if, can I move these guys back? Oh no, there's crude hounds there. Can we get, nope. I think these guys are gonna be done, to be honest. I think they're done. I'd hope that we could heal enough in there that we'd be okay. And we've got some other dudes back there. All right, yeah, we're pretty well toast. All right, the crude hounds went elsewhere. These guys got shot as they got close. But we're almost toast. We're working on it. Let them come, I grow impatient. Units with action points remaining that have ranged weapons automatically perform. Okay. They shall be pure of heart and strong of body, untainted by doubt and unsullied by self-aggrandizement. They will be bright stars on the firmament of battle, angels of death whose shining wings bring swift annihilation to the enemies of man. So shall it be for 1,000 times, for 1,000 years, and to the very end of eternity and the extinction of mortal flesh. All right. You need to, I'm gonna go. And then you're gonna go here. And then here. You don't have enough. All right. Is what it is. We'll try to heal there. Well, we'll click it there. I don't know that it'll matter. Choose research. And they captured the Okuro, whatever, Mabobber. Creases, crack grenade, chaplain would be good. Assault space marines would be good. Let's go chaplain. Intern, let's see if this guy lives. I don't think so. I think this is the end. Yep, it was. With our supply line secured, the chapter is no longer striving. Now we must explore the world and investigate the origin of these unusual warp storms. Yeah, we're kind of getting our butt kicked here. The Vespids are a little bit more powerful than I thought they'd be. Well, at least when there's multiple and they're standing, keep roaring in on you. All right. Well, hopefully the crude hounds don't care about that. I'm kind of wondering about not exploring up there again, if you know what I mean. I'm going to take this back again, I think, if it'll let me. Oh, it won't. I guess the rocks are what slowed us down there. Got some Imperial ruins up there, too. We'll try to grab this and then go over for the... I don't know if the Imperial ruins... Are these all Imperial? These are all Imperial ruins. Never mind. There we go. Okay, so deploy a tactical doctrine. It costs 40. We're making 19 per. I don't know what we need it. It's just plus accuracy. I don't know what that means, really. We do have So you can see right here, we've got damage of 1.5, attacks 1.2 times 5, armor penetration. So there's our accuracy, 67%. Accuracy 8 gets us 67. So if we do that, that's going to get us an extra plus 2, which in theory is going to take us up to accuracy 10, which is going to be, you know, I don't know, get us maybe up to 80. It's not terrible. Do we want to put down, how many of these fortress of... Though every 10 turns. So we could put one of these down here. I guess to kind of help hold this area? Maybe we should have done it before. Well, man, might not have been able to. It has a 10-turn cooldown. And this also is 10. I think we'll just hold off on this. I don't think we need this at the moment. So let's go ahead and end our turn. Oops, into the rocks again took us our three. Order cities, what do we got going on? Oh, we now produce new units. Queue up as many as you like. All right. Keep your war machine in operation. Yeah. Build a resource building like you built the infantry building. The title on the building is placed. May modify the unit's resource output. Okay. Good luck. Yeah. All right. So now we can build. Space Marine City. So now I can build tactical Space Marines. Well, we need at least one, right? And probably another one, but let's go ahead. Should we build our reclusium so we can build our special units? We'll put that in there too. And we'll kind of see, we're probably gonna need more power after that. Yeah, we're down to two. Can we queue? We can queue up another one, right? There we go. So we'll build that afterwards. All right. Exit city. Intern. Okay. Slowly but surely, we're figuring it out. Orcoid fungus, huh? Did that use all of our movement? It used all of our movement. Chaplain. Now to meet the baleful gaze of a Space Marine chaplain is to know that death itself will soon follow. These terrifying warrior priests can be found wherever the fighting is thickest, inspiring their brothers to greatness with every thunderous blow and roared exhortation. All right, 10 armor, 9 hit points, 12 morale, 3 movement, 3 sight, 6 item slots, and 0 cargo slots. Oh, and a flamer and the Crozius Arcanum. Okay, I like that. Extra infantry armor, all right. Hero, last stand increases morale, relentless, Rosarius, terminator armor, and zealot. All right, we've got a lot of stuff here. I'll slowly kind of mouse over them for you. I'll figure these things out as I go, most likely, possibly. Okay, so we can heal. We can deploy the unit from within the city to a target tile. Oh, okay. Of course, we have to build it first. Oh, some crude hounds. They have no armor, 14 hit points. Okay. I just assume not have a lot of this stuff running around out there. What orders, my lord? Choose research. Okay, now we finished the chaplain research. Dormitories? It's probably a good idea if we want to increase our population limit. At some point, we really need to get an armory going, too. Let's get dormitories first, and then maybe we'll double back for it. All right, we'll get an energy. They attacked our building. I wonder if our building can shoot. Why, yes, it can. Just kind of exploring with these guys. See what we're in trees. I see a little tree go up there. And end our turn. Looks like we're probably okay. And it doesn't look like they can take that over. So they're down to 14, or down to 11 from 14. Try it again. Some more crude hounds. Okay. So I believe because we're a building, we've got our guns. We're going to do our full damage, but as we kill them, they're going to do less damage back. So. So they're down to 9. All right. These guys might be level 2? Is that what that means? Yep, they're level 2. Should we roll down here and see? Let's see. A desert? Does that use all 3 of our turns? Why, yes, it does. So we can go ahead and put some shots into these crude hounds. And knock them down to 10 in that one turn. All right, nice. At least they don't take anything over, so kind of while they're sitting there, it's not bad, because it means we're not likely to lose it to the Vespids or anything. Alright. There are only warriors. Oh, that worked. That went well. That went well. Let's go ahead and start moving these dudes out to up here. I'd like to have somebody up here to kind of hold this area. A little bit better. Used all our bits. Okay. So what do we want to build in our city? Now we should be building energy. Can we build it? That's regular Space Marines. All right. So now we can produce a chaplain. We could produce a captain. He's close combat, huh? I think I'm going to go with one of these. I think I'm going to go with one of those. Nice, it gave us the reminder to shoot these guys. And they're down to 7. And now the city can do something as well. I don't know that we have anything to do. We're already building a genitorium and producing a chaplain, so I think we're okay. Intern. Dormitories. Though each battle brother receives his own personal cell, those members of the chapter do not directly enforce the will of the Emperor, share communal quarters spread across the fortress monastery. Support staff, including servants, nurses, and technicians, call these Stark dormitories home. Okay. I think we just shoot them from here. Yeah, keep running. Here, we want them to go there. Yeah, there's not much point in doing anything else yet. I mean, once this is done, maybe we build a dormitory. Requires 1 population op. Okay. So our population right now is 5 of 7, and we need 4. So we're doing okay at the moment. We're growing. We're fine. Choose research. I said we'd come back and get the armory, so let's go ahead and grab that. Exit the city. End the turn. Probably want another unit of Space Marines after this, would be my guess. Execute queued orders, all right. Oh wow, they made it quite a ways that time. And I think we just stick them in there. Order the city. I don't really think it needs anything. I mean, I guess we could build another unit right away. Does have an upkeep of 2. We're doing okay on that. Let's get another one, I guess, underway. Maybe we can run somebody down there and we'll have somebody for kind of all... I was going to say quarters, but we only have 3 of them. Each triad. Is there more terrain there? Can't tell. Did our other guys go? Oh, cargo, they're in there. All right. So they've gone in. I don't know that that matters. We'll see if they can shoot while they're in there, because I don't know. To disembark it, click on a cargo. Okay, does everything get a shoot while we're out here? So if we were then... There's our armory. We'll get back to that in a second. Well, we'll read it. Home to anything that a Marine might employ to purge the battlefield of Xenos and Heretics, from the simplest combat knife to the most redoubtable of relics. The Master of Ordnance keeps close watch on the city chapter's war gear. Only his gene print can grant access to the Titanic underground repository of weapons and vehicles. All right. Give me a second. Let's go ahead. Put him here. And then we'll shoot. We got the Overwatch. Then we had that shot. There we go. Got him down to what, about half? Yeah, 7 of 15. Yep, exactly. Okay, so there's more stuff there. This must be elevation, maybe? Or do you think this is... You think there's water there? I don't know. Order cities. You need to claim more tiles. That's fine. We can buy a new tile here, actually. Acquire tile... Buy that one. Choose research. We've got our armory. Do we want a razorback? I mean, that is kind of the whole point to this. Or do we come up here and maybe grab some land speeders? Yeah, that way we can investigate a little bit better. Fortress expansion. Oh. We'll probably want that too soon. Oh, exit city. In turn. They run away. These guys come in. Yeah, we just mow them down like that. I think that's fine. And these guys will just overwatch them. These guys, I still want to know what's going on up here. Yep, it was definitely just elevation that hid them. Okay. Skip unit. Oh, hold on, I can... I think we can just put them on hold and then they won't do anything. I mean, it won't make us do something until it actually happens. Now, actually, hold on, can we shoot? I don't know that we can. I think elevation is gonna stop us from... That wasn't what I wanted. I mean, it worked, but it wasn't what I was looking for. Let's see. Kind of want to take that. Order cities. What do we got going on in the city? So we've built, we've got that now. What do we need most? We've got requisitions. Probably going to want some more population and more energy. Oh, we need an armory. And then I'm going to build a dormitory. And then another generator. I think that will work. At some point, we're going to want to build some more troops. Oh, hold on. Let's... Oh, we've got troops going on still. Yep. Oh. Where are you going, dude? Yeah, our city's got a fair amount of Overwatch, as it turns out. Can we get there? We can. Can we shoot that dude? We just got a I need a hero, so I'm assuming that means that we actually have a hero. All right, choose your first ability by pressing level up and select your desired ability. Some abilities might be passive, okay. So if we go here, Rites of War increases the damage of the chaplain and adjacent building units, restores morale, increases loyalty output of the fort. Oh, that's not too bad either, because our loyalty at the moment is not spectacular. Let's do that. Right, because if we look, we saw that our loyalty was 6 total. And we'd like more population, which seems to subtract from that. So let's go with that. And then I'm kind of... When does our other unit finish? Soon. Okay. So I'm gonna move him just down to here. I'm gonna move these guys to here. Make sure we control that outpost. And we'll slowly knock them down. They're down to 8. Psychnewen, I guess? Sure. Order cities. What does the city got going on? Not a lot. I mean, we're building a unit. We're building buildings. I mean, we could produce a captain, but I think we're okay for the moment. I think we're okay. I think we can skip the city. And they're gonna go, oh, Ambules, huh? So they've got 20 hit points, but only 6 armor. Morale. Oh ho, ooh ho, ooh ho, huh? okay. They're level 3. 24 death experience. Do I sit here then? As long as we're here, we're getting what? Damage reduction, healing rate, and range damage reduction. Let's sit here for the moment. And you, I'm just gonna put you in there for now. And you, I'm gonna put you down there for now. And you, we'll run you down. And we'll skip you, and we'll order the city, which isn't building anything at the moment. Do we want another unit? We're probably gonna need one, but I think maybe we hold off and we start building some hovercraft. Like, we've got kind of our defenses built now, right? We've got 3 units with a chaplain. I think we're okay, and I think we end this episode here. So thanks for watching, guys. Thumbs up, thumbs down. Don't forget to subscribe. And remember, the Emperor protects. See you next time. Cheers.